In her first national TV interview since her racist tweet cost Roseanne Barr her TV show, she turned straight to the camera and apologized to former Obama administration official Valerie Jarrett.
I'm sorry that you feel harmed and hurt. I never meant that. And for that, I apologize.
In the May tweet, Barr said that if the Muslim Brotherhood and the Planet of Apes had a baby, it would look like Jarrett, who is African American. She told Fox News' Sean Hannity that the tweet was purely political and had to do with the administration's stance on Iran. Barr also said how horrifying it was for her, a Jewish woman, to be called a racist. Also in the spotlight today, the founder and former CEO and chairman of the board of Papa John's, John Shatner, is now suing his former company, claiming the company treated him in a, quote, unexplained and heavy-handed way, after a Forbes article reported that he used a racial slur during a media training session. All right, we're going to bring in our friend Dr. Jeffrey Gardier, psychologist. Dr. Gardier, we just watched this video with Roseanne from last night on Fox News, and we've had news out about the Papa John's founder potentially now litigating the issue that happened. What are your thoughts? I mean, why bring these things up again after they've been hashed out in public? What goes on through their minds to, you know, kind of relitigate this?
Well, I think they really worked through a lot of these issues on their own. They question a lot of their own motivation. They question some of their perceptions, some of their understanding. I think with both of these individuals, you see a little bit of remorse, and then you see that they start making excuses again. So they haven't totally resolved the issues in their own heads, and I think they're working that out in public, which may not be the best place because we're not getting any real benefit from that.
Do you see any value in the public eye where she'll have any benefit from this? I mean, you know, the interview kind of went all over the place last night. I mean, is there any value that she's going to receive from doing this?
Well, I think the value that she'll receive is that she will get a lot of feedback from people who may say we feel sorry for her, or that she doesn't really see the light as to what's going on, or maybe she needs to get continued mental health care, since she has admitted herself that she's gotten treatment in the past for multiple personality disorders. So it takes shows like yours and perhaps people like me, psychologists working with media personalities, to get them to reconcile what's going on and to grow from these situations and to become better individuals.
Thanks, Dr. Gardier. All right, we're going to go to our A-plus panel and bring it back in, Bob and Lisa. So we've both seen this video of Roseanne. We've heard about the Papa John's founder. What do you think, Bob? I mean, is there any value at all in hanging out? We hear what Dr. Gardier just said. I mean, you know, what did you see last night? What do you think about this?
I think they're both different in my mind. But with respect to Roseanne, I agree with Dr. Gardier. He essentially hits the spot. This is how they air their own personal turmoil and tumult. The public eye, they can't stay away from it.
Can we talk about race in a humorous way,
yes,
in a political way? Is
yes.
there an appropriate way to do this, Lisa? And, you know, I certainly didn't look like that was the case with Roseanne,
right,
but
right.
How can we do this?
Okay, can I look at a camera? I need to do something. All white people, you can never say the N-word under any circumstances ever, period.com, my Tamar impression. Now, the thing is, yes, we can talk about race, and I think that the Papa John situation, he said that he was in some kind of like diversity kind of thing, and it was within context. Even if you're doing a diversity training, talking about the tough issues and race, there's never a reason why even a black person, especially a white person in a training scenario, would use the N-word. And then he used it in such a way that he said, well, you know, Colonel Sanders said it back in the day, and he didn't get in trouble. So in essence, are you saying that, why can't I? Like, it's really terrible. Roseanne should shut the bleep up. Bleep! Girl, bye. I think she is off her meds. I'm not being shady. She really is off her meds. Her personalities are all over the place, and she's just a liar.
Bob, real quick, Papa John's founder is going to sue now. Any hope he's going to get anywhere with this litigation?
You know, I see his case completely different than Roseanne. He made a mistake, clearly. But gosh, we punish people. He founded this place and whatever, and he left voluntarily, from what I understand, even though they asked him to go. He essentially, legally, he resigned. So to now sue the board of
directors. He was absolutely fired.
He wasn't fired.
You're fired.
There's a different term in the law when you voluntarily resign, even if you're doing it at the behest of the board of directors, you resign. To now sue them is just basically saying, I'm having a second thought about it. But I have to be honest with you. Do we have no more more room in our culture to say, I made a huge mistake, I shouldn't have done
it,
and that you can't keep your job.
Well,
we don't have any more room for the show tonight, so we'll have to come back and deal with it another time. I want to thank you guys very much. This is a good conversation. We'll keep
having it. He got busted. That was a mistake.